we haven't really got to see Method Black on their Rogue Mage too much, but they are phenomenal Rogue Mage players, of course, throughout history. So this will be quite a treat, whereas Change My Mind playing the composition that had them succeed so much so at the Spring Finals. So these two Titans going head-to-head in the upper bracket. Waz trying to find Minpoike in the starting room, but not finding him. Able to avoid being sapped, which is very important when facing a Rogue as a healer. But Chaz actually sneaks in. Minpoike wanted to be in bear form in case they tried to attack him, but in bear form, you can be hibernated. At the same time, Valet counter-engaging crowd control with a mind bomb. It's still acro on the back foot despite it. Minpoike has managed to stabilize with Iron Bark. Waz gets denied on his Vendetta with a kidney shot from acro. Waz pulling the trigger on that cooldown very early on. Acro still has his available, so he can amplify his damage at any moment, and Chaz will not have Iron Bark to deal with it. Raikou not running the Temporal Shield, so maybe a target later on. Of course, the Kleptomania very effective against a Restoration Druid. Acro still the target for Method Black. They're focusing down the Rogue. This does mean that Valet on Shadow Priest could be left open. Another Hibernate found by Chaz. This is beautifully done, well set up by Raikou and Chaz. It is really putting Change My Mind behind.
Yeah, I mean, it was a nice Hibernate, but there was a Ring of Frost down as well. It was more fancy than anything. There's not too much you could do as a Restoration Druid during that double cast, and I think that really speaks volumes to the teamwork of Raikou and Chaz. Like you were saying, if they both cast out the Hibernate and the Polymorph for Ring of Frost at the same time, can be really difficult to deal with as a Restoration Druid. Actually, a defensive blind coming in from Waz onto Acro. I guess Waz feels like he was in a little bit of trouble. They're actually going to be going after Minpoike here, trying to put some pressure onto him. I believe he's actually running the Balance Affinity in this matchup, so could be a great target for Waz and Raikou to run after and really pressure down.
Although they leave Acro and Valet open to maximize their damage if they do it, so double-edged sword, he is the most easy to kill target really in terms of defense with that Balance Affinity, but at the same time, Shadow Priest free casting is very threatening, so Method Black have given up on the chase towards Minpoike and are now actually going after Valet. Method Black have been mixing it up throughout this entire game, even just in the first couple of minutes. They've attacked every single target on the team, and that they're trying to put Change My Mind off footing and try and find a kill by surprise really with these target swaps, whereas Change My Mind are sticking with the consistency and going only after Waz. They've gotten perfect crowd control here onto Chaz, a mind bomb into a sap, but Waz anticipates the damage and repositions far away from Chaz, so Acro has to make a decision to either crowd control Chaz or attack Waz, and he can't do both. And because he can't do both, he's not going to kill Waz, so that was good positioning on Waz's part. Now he baits Acro to overextend, punishing him and pulling both of Acro's defensive cooldowns. This is very well done by Waz.
Yeah, really good positioning, baiting Acro, and that's not the first time we've seen that happen when these two rogues go head-to-head. Acro had to trade out his Trinket, his Evasion, and Cloak of Shadow, so he's very vulnerable. Valet, of course, with the Trinket, with the Void Shift, that extra Shadow Priest utility and defensive cooldown is going to be really big for Change My Mind in order to survive another big setup. If we look at mana right now, Minpoike a little bit behind. There's just been really good consistent pressure. Like you said, Zed, Raikou and Waz have really been keeping Change My Mind guessing, going after all three targets. Acro getting swapped to here. Minpoike looks to deflect it with the Iron Bark. That should be enough, but just massive damage coming in from Raikou.
Acro cycloned at low health by Chaz. Scary moment here. Another cyclone. If Minpoike gets crowd controlled, it could be the end of the game. Big hit incoming. Will he fall here? Raikou has to solo him. Waz is stunned, but Waz is coming out of that stun shortly. Acro's on the run, looking to escape. Had to use his Vanish defensively, so he's not going to be able to use that to get a sap out of a Mind Bomb. Minpoike is still crowd controlled. Method Black switched their attention to Valet. They're just maximizing output in terms of damage to try and kill maybe two targets at the same time. While Minpoike's locked down, Valet gets cycloned on his Vampiric Embrace. The crowd control from Method Black is perfect at this point in the match. It's really making it difficult for Minpoike to recover and heal. You can see a lead in mana already established for Method Black, so winning on crowd control, which is kind of expected with the Mage versus the Shadow Priest, but also winning on pressure, winning on mana, winning on cooldown, so it is looking good for Method Black in game number one.
Yeah, Waz, Acro still just sort of poking each other. Finally, Acro is going to be making a target change over to Raikou. He's been doing a good job in this matchup with Polymorph, with getting out damage, so maybe going after the Mage in this matchup could be a little bit more advantageous for Change My Mind, just to slow him down. But anytime Raikou gets targeted, he plays very defensive, never really looking for the crowd control, just running away, and it makes him very difficult to take down. Chaz getting caught into his sap. Decent pressure on Raikou, but it's Acro that's in trouble. Minpoike forces a Trinket if Waz is blind. Now there's no Trinket left. If the next time Minpoike gets stunned, Raikou could move in with a Ring of Frost and a Hibernate from Chaz. There's really no answer Minpoike has, but they're opting to just go after him. Nice life grip there, leap of faith from Valet in order to keep Minpoike alive. And I think that play should be enough for him to survive. But Method Black, they're just going for it.
They're going all in, popping the Vendetta, still trying to keep Change My Mind on their toes and perhaps just kill them.
Whoa! Right,
big attack here by Raikou. That's going to be Void Shift. Valet switching his health for Minpoike's right before Minpoike died. And now they actually switch to the Shadow Priest, which is a common strategy when Void Shift is used. Valet is holding on without having to use Dispersion, which is good for his team overall. They would be almost guaranteed to lose if they did have to use both at the same time, but they may still. I mean, the pressure from Method Black is so high. Acro tries to stabilize, but Minpoike's crowd control. Dispersion has to be traded. Valet almost going down through it. Acro disrupts the polymorph, allowing Minpoike to get out of crowd control, but Waz continues the chain, using the kidney shot for crowd control rather than damage. Good adaptation here to get another polymorph. Perfect crowd control chain by Method Black. Is looking to secure the game. Game number one to Method Black. Very important to win the blind pick so you can have the swing.
Shut some of that down.
Yeah, maybe the fried food doesn't belong in the sewer. Well, I mean, at least for a few hours. But Method Black are one game up here, looking to go two up in the series.
I don't want to taste anything in the sewers, Adrian, okay? And we see Mindseer onto Acro to try and find a member of the opposing team in stealth. Sap on Minpoike. This could be devastating if Method Black can engage. Acro, though, intercepts Waz, saving Minpoike from the initial attack. Although now Waz looks to reverse it. Good adaptation despite being caught. Method Black secure crowd control onto three members, which is exactly what they need to do to force significant defensive cooldowns. They're still not getting it. They're not finding even an Iron Bark for that first attack. That is unfortunate for Method Black. Change my mind in a stable position. Method Black switching targets to go after Valet. I do like this from Method Black, yeah. Is that they're not sticking to one specific strategy. They're always switching targets, keeping Change My Mind on their toes. One main advantage of this is that Minpoike has to spend a lot of mana because he has to have heal over time effects on three members of the team rather than only on one member of the team. So Method Black at least secure a guaranteed victory through mana by switching targets. They also can get surprise kills if the enemy team isn't ready for a swap. And I do like the swaps from Method Black. I think that is going to be key to their victory overall in the series. Change my mind on the other hand. Their crowd control chains have been a bit slow. It feels like they're always waiting a little bit longer than they really need to start a crowd control chain. And then without crowd control, Chaz is just easily healing through the damage. So I would like to see more silence mind bombs or bash cyclones from Change My Mind. I'd like to just see them play a bit more aggressive, a little less defensive, but maybe they're forced to play so defensive because of Method Black switching targets so frequently.
I think switching targets, switching where you're dealing damage is important, but another big thing is Raikou's able to just switch up his polymorph. So if they go after Valet, then they polymorph up Acro. And once Acro, you know, he's going to survive because he has all those heal over time effects, that's when they can just put a polymorph on Acro. And because of that, they're really just limiting the damage. You can see Valet, he's just, you know, munching on those polymorphs right now. Pork is having a difficult time actually, you know, dispelling him out and freeing him up. Waz on the run, Acro trying to generate some pressure. Good crowd control over onto Chaz. Waz behind the pillar in a good position in line of sight of Chaz. Does connect some of those heals, and I think he's actually going to be able to get a re-stealth here, which will be big.
Waz blinded Acro and then auto-attacked it.
I think it was a pet, wasn't it?
Was it a pet? I mean, either way, that's your most powerful crowd control. I was wondering why it was even on the rogue, if that was just a mistake outright, or if they had a plan for it, and then it just went haywire. Method Black making another switch, going after the healer on Change My Mind. And Poike was ready, had Barkskin available, and Valet backed him up by pulling him back to the boxes so that he could line of sight. Acro is then pressuring Waz, so when the enemy team has a rogue, a warrior, a death knight, some sort of melee class, and they're attacking your healer, it is usually a good idea to either crowd control that melee or go after them and try and force them away from your healer. So in this situation, Acro is attacking Waz, preventing him from chasing down Minpoike, who he would like to be attacking and forcing cooldowns from. Still the mana in favor of Method Black, although we do finally see pressure for Change My Mind with Raikou and Waz hovering at about 60% health. Double crowd control cast by Method Black, denied though by Mass Dispel of Valet, immediate reaction there. Acro trying to catch Waz again with a smoke bomb play, but almost zero to the damage taken in that attempt. That's usually a very scary moment when a rogue uses a smoke bomb, but Waz takes zero damage as a result of it and now can start playing a lot more aggressive.
All right, he's going to be moving in. Acro still the target of choice. Good crowd control coming in from Raikou once again. They just can't find the crowd control on him in Poike. They actually make a swap. Akro trying to back him up, but he's crowd controlled up. Waz on a solo mission. Frozen Orb finally gets dropped in. Raikou in a good position to finally get some damage rolling. That position was nice from Npoike. He manages to leap away, dispel off the Gladiator's Maledict. Another one flies in from Raikou, but I think Npoike will ultimately survive. A nice little Kleptomania spell steal on that. Innervate Raikou, making sure to strip that from Npoike so he doesn't get those free heal overtime effects. That's going to tax his mana even more. But if we look at mana, despite the fact that Method Black, they've been all over the place, Npoike has been able to manage his mana quite well, and he's actually relatively even with Chaz.
Yep, they definitely need to keep that in mind, as this will inevitably play out for mana and dampening if either team can't find a kill with crowd control and pressure. Valet getting switched to by Method Black. They get Glider's Medallion from him, and that's usually, you want to use that with Void Shift. So later on, Method Black can punish Valet for using that Gladiator's Medallion a bit prematurely. It wasn't, I don't think it was very required when Dispersion was available. Smoke Bomb is also a good punish on using that Glider's Medallion. Valet can't escape the Smoke Bomb too easily without being able to get out of crowd control. Blind was used on Npoike, so they've got Npoike's Glider's Medallion, and they've got Valet's Glider's Medallion. When two players are down that, they cannot remove crowd control. This is a big opportunity for Method Black to make a push to end the game, perhaps another switch to Npoike. Currently, Method Black are pulling away from the enemy team, perhaps trying to bait Npoike to push forward or just set up a drink if they don't. They have to make a move quickly. Chaz is regenerating mana. Method Black go for the swap to the healer while Npoike moved into center field. Chaz gets full mana. Npoike falls behind on cooldowns, and this is looking grim in game two.
Yeah, definitely not the best situation to be in. Kitty shot now onto Raikou. Chaz denies that with the Iron Bark. We're at 3% dampening. Mind Bomb coming in. These crowd control chains finally starting to develop themselves for Change My Mind, but they just haven't really been getting too many defensive cooldowns. You know, Raikou has both of his ice blocks. Waz in a good position with his trinket, Cloak of Shadows, evasion. And Poike falling behind. Another setup here onto Akro. Good burst damage coming in from Raikou. Ray of Frost being fully channeled. Waz with the Vanish cheap shot, extending the crowd control chain. Akro trying to survive. He has the evasion up, trying to just avoid a lot of this incoming damage from Waz with that, giving him some additional evasion. Waz with a beautiful Shadow Step kick into a Polymorph on the leg. Good control here from Method Black. And now Akro's frozen. He's in a Cyclone. Can't get healed up by Npoike. Npoike trying to sneak away for a drink, but he's kind of left Akro behind. He's in a Kitty shot. He has to trinket. He has the evasion just relying on, or he has the Vanish just relying on that Faint for now. Big burst damage from Raikou and Waz. Akro could be in some trouble. Npoike finally backing him up. Keep in mind, Valet has the Void Shift if he needs it. He can swap his hit points with Akro at any moment, but I have to say, this matchup is looking as one-sided as Negrand Arena. Method Black just seems to be ahead in all regards.
I think at this point, if you're changing my mind and you end up losing this game, you have to switch composition. This is just not looking good at all for them. Method Black were more than prepared. Changed my mind, looked to try and pull off a miracle, but Chaz totally denied it. Iron Barking before Smoke Bomb, Iron Barking before being crowd controlled. He read them like a book and totally shut down what would have otherwise been a big push, an opportunity to perhaps win the game or at least get significant defensive cooldowns. But now they basically get nothing. Dampening continues to get higher, and Minpoike's mana doesn't, so Chaz is chasing down Npoike to stop him from drinking. The pressure is still mounting on Akro. He's got no defense for 26 seconds. Big opportunity for Method Black, but Change My Mind and Defiance are trying to kill Waz at the same moment in time, at least pulling Cloak of Shadows from him, and at least keeping it close in terms of cooldowns. Frozen Orb to stop Npoike from drinking. Beautifully done from Raikou. It's all about stopping that mana regeneration at this point. I would have anticipated that the Shadow Priest team would focus on sustained pressure and a mana advantage, but it's actually Method Black that have the lead. It's just so impossible at this point for Npoike to drink if Method Black stay on top of him, even just committing the Water Elemental to chase down Npoike. Perhaps they just kill Npoike, catching him out of form downstairs. Akro tries to support. Ursul's Vortex on that Life Grip. Beautifully done by Chaz. Total shutout, honestly, by Method Black. In every single regard, they are in the lead.
Yeah, with this composition, they just have complete control of the game. But Waz is in a little bit of trouble. He's got no Cloak of Shadows. He's got no Trinket. Maybe he overstayed his welcome. Chaz has a little bit of catch-up to do, but if he does keep him alive, he's got a massive mana lead. In the meantime, Npoike was able to sneak away. Is he going to be able to recover some mana? Raikou chases him down. Npoike only got the smallest a bit of mana recovered, but now you can see Raikou is just entangling, rooted out of line of sight. Can't really do much in this fight. Waz on a solo mission, trying to get some pressure rolling onto Valet until Raikou can get back into the fight. Cyclone on Npoike. Valet could be in a little bit of trouble. He does have a lot of defensive cooldowns available if he really needs them, but I think he should be able to hold on. Once Npoike gets out of the Cyclone, he should be able to easily top him off. Nice shadow step kick from Acro onto Chaz, but Raikou with these polymorphs has just been severely limiting any damage output Change My Mind can really develop.
I mean, at this point, you have to kill Waz. Raikou has two more ice blocks. That's too many cooldowns to work through. Can they kill Waz before they're just totally tapped out? Valet disperses during smoke bomb. Fair trade there, but won't have dispersion in a minute now for Vendetta. That's very deadly moment of opportunity for Method Black. If they can make it to that point, though, they've got Chaz crowd controlled. They don't get any follow-up, and that's... Oh, they finally do. They get the Cyclone on Chaz, but Acro is polymorphed away. Raikou immediately Frost Novaing Acro out of the chain. Acro just not moving for such a substantial amount of time, and now Method Black look to counter-engage. No one can deny the crowd control. Minpoike is taken out of the fight. Valet is so low and healthy. Wants to Void Shift and save the Glider's Medallion,
oh,
but he's out of line
of sight.
He's out of line of sight and can't switch his health to break the polymorph. Unfortunate for Change My Mind, but even if they did, they were just getting owned in game two. Pride Kitty must just not be available.
They need to change my schedule, change my composition, change everything to Change My Mind, because at this point, Method Black, it looks like they're going to be walking away with the series. I don't even know what strategy Change My Mind could really go with. It just feels like the Frost Mage in this matchup, with the way they're playing it, really just abusing the fact that they have Polymorph, able to just crowd control up Acro whenever they're on Valet, and vice versa, they get crowd control on Valet anytime they go after Acro. It just allows them so much momentum in this matchup.
I mean, look, already Method Black crowd controlling two members of the team with decent pressure on Valet. If they can hold out and get a dispersion only or an Iron Bark only, that would be likely the best result, or the best result would be not having to use any cooldowns at all. These polymorphs from Raikou have been on point. Anytime Waz is stunned or Chaz is stunned, he instantly polymorphs Acro and stops him from attacking during the stun, which is a crucial moment in time to crowd control an enemy player. And he's been doing it instantaneously every single time, which is why Acro just can't get anything going. Then Method Black recover, and they begin to counterattack. I really am impressed with Method Black's Rogue Mage Druid synergy, considering we haven't seen it a lot from them this year at all. They've been focusing mostly on that Demon Hunter Death Knight and a couple Spellcaster Cleaves, so they're coming back strong with this Rogue Mage Druid. And I mean, it's looking like they're going to be able to clean this series up 3-0. I don't want to count Change My Mind totally out, because they have been on a bit of a tear, but so far in this series, it just feels like they're playing slow, just not engaging crowd control nearly as frequently or on the right targets at the right time, and Method Black is just being able to smack them around.
Yeah, I mean, they just have complete control. It seems like, from watching this matchup, Method Black does have a compositional advantage. That's why we really wanted to see Change My Mind bring in their Rogue Mage Druid, at least for a mirror match, but it doesn't look like it's going to be able to happen. Of course, Change My Mind, they still have a chance in this matchup, but it's an uphill battle on Ashermain's Fall, and they are just one game away from being sent down to the lower bracket to play against Wildcard Gaming once again. I have to see how that plays out a little bit later on. If Change My Mind can't hold on, good pressure here on the Waz, though. Nice little feint is going to be denying a lot of that incoming damage. Now Kidden Shot onto Valea. We'll have to see if Benfoyke can keep him alive. Chaz moving forward, securing some crowd control. Bash into Cyclone. And another one of the problems that Valet has on the Shadow Priest is he doesn't have a ranged interrupt like Raikou. So anytime Chaz wants to move in, get the bash into the Cyclone, there's not too many ways they can stop it. Of course, Valet, he has the Mass Dispel, which he was able to get off to free up Benfoyke from some of that crowd control. But without that ranged interrupt, your healer is just so much more susceptible to being bullied by the enemy druid.
Yeah, Chaz is drinking and Valet is at low health, so Method Black can regenerate. Actually, not. I'm very surprised that he didn't just continue to sit down and regenerate mana. They still had so much pressure. He's actually very far behind. This is at least something going in favor of Change My Mind. They have a lot more of a mana advantage. Decent pressure right now on Waz. Perhaps they can turn this around and it reverse sweep if they keep this up. They need to stop Chaz from drinking, which makes me wonder why they picked one of the easiest maps for a druid to drink on if this was going to be their plan to try and out-pressure Method Black. Chaz is looking for that drink, and Minpoike is shutting him down. They're going to have to keep their eyes on Chaz this entire game. If at any point he can regenerate back to full mana, they're going to lose the advantage.
Yeah, Valet gets put into a frost over behind the pillar. Really can't get anything rolling. Minpoike there for a nice little dispel. But at this point, it's difficult for them. Bash on them in Poike. Cyclone once again. Acro getting swapped here. Big kidney shot and big damage. Valet might have to help him out with that Void Shift. He wants to hold on. Cloak of Shadows is enough for now, but if they can get the Cyclone onto Acro, is Chaz going to be able to do it? He gets silenced up. Good denial there by Valet. If he can cyclone him at low health, this is going to be a disaster situation for Change My Mind. In the meantime, though, Waz in a little bit of trouble. Full sap onto Chaz, and now it's Waz. He's in so much trouble. No Cloak of Shadows, no evasion, no trinket. He's left all alone, but Acro just can't get there. Raikou, beautiful crowd control, deny anything Change My Mind can do. Waz manages to hold on.
Once again, Raikou stalling the game. Perfect aggression, perfect defense. Acro was clutch there, almost getting a kill on Waz. Beautifully sapped onto Chaz, and then shadow stepping the evasion to get behind Waz, which evasion otherwise denies all melee attackers, but if you get behind the target, it doesn't do anything. So Acro uses shadow step. This places his rogue behind the target. He did that instantaneously, stunning up Waz and creating a situation where they almost got a kill. Perhaps if they can repeat that a few times, they could find victory. They still have a pretty big mana lead, but Chaz is running off into the corner. If Chaz sits down for any sort of mana regeneration, I don't think Change My Mind can take this anymore. He's sitting down. No one stopped him. How much mana? Not too much, actually. He comes back into the fight. He's a bit worried about Waz because the pressure overall from Change My Mind is a lot higher than Game 1 and Game 2. Acro caught in a smoke bomb. Waz looking for the power play. Big hit on that Comet Storm. Acro in so much trouble at this point.
Belay
cannot void shift. He's in crowd control. He needs to be dispelled. Acro gets cycloned at low health. Belay is interrupted, but not on Shadow. He can use the void shift. He needs to time it perfectly. He gets crowd controlled again. He's unable to. If he gets cycloned, it's easily GG. He is not Cyclone. He can use it. They're holding on. They're trying to be greedy in this position, but I don't know if this is a position where you can really get away with it. He's trying to, against all odds, hold on to dear life, and Poike gets in. Surely they'll have to use Void Shift at this point. I mean, honestly, the Void Shift finally comes out. Changed my mind holding on to that until the absolute last second.
Yeah, that was a bit of a disaster situation. Valet was the only thing that could keep Acro alive, and actually just ran into a ring of frost. It wasn't even placed on top of him, almost throwing away that particular moment in the game, but ultimately does manage to hold on. Now getting swapped to his low health from the Void Shift. He uses Shadow Meld on one of the incoming Gladiator's Maledicts, but he's still in trouble, and Poike is going to have to play catch up. He has the Iron Bark, but opting not to use it. Valet with a lot of self-healing with that Vampiric Embrace. Can Waz and Raikou sort of push through full blind on him? And Poike, what is Valet going to do? Using the Greater Fade, trying to get out of line of sight, trying to keep himself alive. Full Polymorph now secured with the Kidney Shot. Dispersion has to be used, but you can see now Valet, he is such a vulnerable target. And Poike, still no trinket for 40 seconds. Valet, no dispersion, no trinket, no void shift, no anything. Acro is going to have to pull out some sort of miracle in order to keep him alive.
Chaz is going for a drink. If Poike moves to stop him, then he can't heal Valet. So Chaz is likely to regenerate a lot of mana, or Valet will die. It's basically checkmate for Change My Mind. It's
one match
point, and Poike is cyclone. There's nothing left. Valet gets crushed.
Oh!
The blind?
The blind on the Waz. Can Valet survive? No. Big shatter combo coming in from Raikou. And honestly, he all.
Feed versus the fake zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.